Let's suppose you are skateboarding, and while skateboarding, you lose your balance and you fall towards your right. Now, what would you do in such scenario? In such scenario, you would move your body slightly towards the left to re-establish the stability. Likewise, in a system or in a reaction, if there are a lot of reactants being used up or products being formed, to regain the stability or to regain the equilibrium, the system will undo the entire change. This principle was given by a scientist called as Le Chatelier. So Le Chatelier gave a principle wherein he said that if an reaction or if an equilibrium is disturbed by the change in temperature, pressure or concentration, then the system will try to undo the change and regain the stability. For this, let us understand using certain examples. Let us take the first factor which can affect the equilibrium. Let us take concentration. Now, for that, we have a reaction A plus B giving me C plus D. In this reaction, if I increase the concentration of A or B, which are my reactants, the equilibrium is disturbed. In such scenario, the equilibrium will try to regain its stability. And how will it do so? It will produce more products such that the concentrations again become constant. So, if in case the concentration of reactants are increased or the products are decreased, the reaction tends to move in the forward direction, producing more products. Or if the concentration of reactants decrease or products increase, the reaction tends to move in the backward direction, consuming more products. This was the effect of concentration. Let us move on to the second factor, that is pressure. To understand pressure, let us take a very famous equation in chemistry that is called as Haber's process. So in Haber's process, 1 mole of nitrogen reacts with 3 moles of hydrogen to produce 2 moles of ammonia. In this case, if the pressure is increased, more moles of nitrogen and hydrogen will react, more molecules will collide, producing more moles of ammonia. So, in case if we are producing ammonia using Haber's process, it is recommended to use very high pressure so that we can get more yield of ammonia. Likewise, if I decrease the pressure here, the reaction tends to move to the side with more moles, which means on decreasing the pressure, ammonia would start to get consumed. So, we cannot be adamant that on increasing the pressure, reaction will always move in forward or backward. It entirely depends upon the number of moles or the stoichiometries of each of the reactants or products. This was the effect of pressure on the equilibrium. Let us move on to the third and very important factor, that is the temperature. What happens if I increase the temperature? On increasing the temperature, endothermic reactions are favored, and on decreasing the temperature, exothermic reactions are favored. Let us take a similar scenario of Haber's process wherein we are forming ammonia. the entire reaction of formation of ammonia is an exothermic process, which means it should happen at relatively low temperature. But the question is, what would happen if the temperature is increased substantially? If the temperature is increased, ammonia would now start to decompose and produce more nitrogen and hydrogen. In such scenarios, the yield of ammonia will decrease and hence it is not recommended. So, if you are changing the temperature, we need to entirely see whether the reaction is endothermic or exothermic. This was the effect of temperature. Let us move on to the fourth and the final effect, that is catalyst. How would a catalyst change the reaction or change the equilibrium? What is a catalyst in the first place? A catalyst is a substance which alters the speed of reaction or the rate of reaction by changing the activation energy. So if I add a catalyst to a reaction, it decreases the activation energy, thereby increasing the rate of reaction. But if I add a catalyst to a reversible reaction, it would increase the speed of both forward and backward to the same extent. Thereby, there will be no change as such in the entire equilibrium, which means that catalyst will not affect the equilibrium at all. So what we saw here are the effects of temperature, pressure, concentration, and catalyst on the equilibrium or on the reaction. To obtain more yield of any product, how would you play with these terms will be very important. To understand more about how acids and bases would dissociate, stay tuned with Tutorac.